on and talk about mast cell tumors and kind of one of the things that can be one of the most frustrating things of our practices. What's most important is this really is truly the most common cutaneous tumor that you're going to see in dogs, and it's been rated as high as 21%. You guys probably know most of the big players, and boxers definitely have to be mentioned when it comes to mast cells, as well as Boston Terriers, Labs, Beagles, Schnauzers. One thing you don't see on this list, which I would say in my experience, is pugs. We definitely see an increased risk, and as well today I saw another little Maltese with one of these. So just hasn't been picked up in some of the studies, but I think in your practices you kind of start to recognize the players. Fortunately for boxers, even though they're one of the ones that develops them most commonly, they do most often develop a well-differentiated or a lower-grade form, which is good for them. Sharpeys are the ones that develop the aggressive form, and the question I always get from clients is, well, is this because they have bad skin? Is this because they have higher allergies or whatnot? And really nothing's been truly connected directly with Sharpeys as far as what the cause is. But I tend to see these in Sharpeys, and they tend to be the ones that start out as a little red spot on the hock or a little red spot somewhere down near the toe or the popliteal region, and next thing you know, the entire back leg is eaten up with one of these. So they can be very aggressive in Sharpeys. So again, let's go back to the mast cell granules, because often enough, these can cause a lot of the clinical signs that we see in patients, unfortunately. And as I think about it over the years, I've seen mast cell tumors, and I have a couple of pictures in here for you guys to see, that can be literally the size of a volleyball or a basketball that do not have any clinical side effects. But the unfortunate thing is I can see them as large as just a pencil eraser, and they can have clinical side effects. And it really does depend on just the potency of those granules and how much of that histamine and such is being released. The big thing that I want everybody to take home is they can look like anything, and they truly can. They can be hairless, they can be non-haired, under the skin, they can be rapidly growing, they can sit there for years, owners will report them sitting there doing nothing, and then they become ulcerated. But the truth is they can be located anywhere in the body. They can be solitary to multiple ones. As I mentioned before, we can see slow to very rapidly growing and ulcerated ones. And as we talked about earlier, you know, with the clinical signs, owners will often say they were swollen and then they went away, it seemed like a bug bite. And that's very often the presentation that we see.